to begin by asking Shuichi a question, since this class trial was his idea. What exactly is the point of this class trial?
Yeah! Why are we having a class trial if no one died? Whoa! My voice was way louder than I expected. I might be on a roll today.
Hey! I'm no slouch at being a loudmouth either!
Me too!
Monodem's voice is super soft, though. Everyone cool with him getting blown up?
You said that the killing game would end if you exposed the truth at the class trial. So, you bastards, what is the purpose of this class trial?
Oh, that's a good question!
But his voice was quiet.
Does voice volume not matter at all?
The purpose of this class trial?
All right, I'll give you an answer. The reason I called for this trial is...
No, that's not the problem. Oh. Hey, say something already! Sorry, it didn't say to expose the mastermind, which is what I thought was the purpose. It's this. Retry a past case. Some new evidence has come forward.
I wish to retry a past case.
A retrial?
For which case?
The first one. The murder of Rantaro Amami. I've found new evidence relevant to the case.
Is this, like, the game kind of going against the death penalty? Because this is often an argument against the death penalty, is that sometimes what happens is that we end up killing someone who didn't commit the crime.
In light of that evidence, I demand a retrial.
What's the point of a retrial? The result of the first class trial has already been settled!
Yeah, yeah!
What if our vote was wrong?
Wrong? Monokuma said the blackened for that incident was Kaede.
Are you saying he was wrong?
Madam Kid, your reactions are too extreme! It's making the rest of us look bad!
Oh, oh shit! He's already got the detonator!
To test the validity of our vote, we're going to retry the entire case. If Monokuma was wrong, the validity of these trials would be in question. The entire killing game wouldn't make sense anymore.
I see. You think you can destroy the game by calling out my failure as the game master.
You shouldn't have a problem with this if you have nothing to hide, Monokuma.
So in the end, the first case has become the focal point yet again. What a twist! What an interesting twist! Okay, let's do this!
So what is this new truth?
There are several. But before we go any further, I want to discuss Rantaro's talent.
Did you learn what his talent was?
Rantaro's ultimate talent was a mystery. But now I know.
He was the ultimate survivor.
Ultimate survivor?
I saw it too. He said so in his video.
Well, the truth is, this isn't your first killing game. You're the ultimate survivor. You survived the last killing game. That's why you get this perk, the survivor perk.
Rantaro became the ultimate survivor after surviving a past killing game. After his memory was wiped, he participated in the killing game once again.
So this wasn't Rantaro's first killing game?
Why did he participate in a second killing game?
I'm not sure yet. But after I learned that Rantaro was the ultimate survivor, I deduced his objective.
Rantaro's objective?
The reason he went to the library before he was killed, and why he knew about the hidden door.
Didn't he just happen to randomly notice the hidden door?
That's what I thought at the time, but it appears that assumption was false. There was an actual reason Rantaro knew about the door.
Yes, that reason is... Survivor perk.
That's it! Rantaro was given this monopad as a kind of survivor perk. It has a map of the entire academy, including areas that had not yet been unlocked. Of course, that includes the hidden room.
To think Rantaro was given that as a survivor perk.
He found out about the hidden room with this map?
The monopad also contained a video Rantaro recorded for himself.
If the Mastermind ever needed a spare Monokuma, they would head to the hidden room.
The message was what inspired him to go to the library to investigate the hidden room.
A time limit is now in effect. If a murder does not occur by nighttime 2 days from now, then every student forced to participate in this killing game will die, mauled to shreds by countless Monokumas from the rumored Monokuma-making machine.
The Mastermind would have gone to that room to mass-produce Monokuma once time ran out. So in order to figure out who the Mastermind was, Rantaro went to the hidden room at the back of the library just before time ran out.
That's right. Rantaro must have come to the same conclusion that Kaede and I did.
It sure is ironic that the ultimate survivor died because of Kaede's trap.
But if Rantaro had a clue like that, why didn't he come to us with it?
I assume because he didn't trust us. The killing game had just started, after all. What he said in his video message certainly didn't help either. He told himself to only share this information with people he could trust.
He didn't have any recollection of filming this message, right? That means he must have had trouble believing it as well.
It was probably confusing to him, too. That's why he didn't consult us.
Why the long face? It's nothing. I figure no one would listen to some guy who can't even remember his own talent, right? This is exactly what Monokuma wants us to do. So what else is part of his plan? Is my memory part of it too? If it is, then... can I even trust myself?
He didn't know if he could trust that video, or trust us, or even trust himself. He must have been so lost. But with the time limit approaching, he decided to take a chance.
Shh. There's no need for that, because I'm going to end this killing... to end this game. I've already decided. You're going to end this game? It's not about outfoxing everyone in this killing game. It's about ending the game itself. That's the real goal. Can you even accomplish such a feat? I wouldn't be saying this if I didn't think I could.
So we went to the library alone, without telling anyone.
And then he got killed by Kaede's trap.
The only people who knew about the hidden door at that time were Rantaro and I. I had Kaede with me, and I thought I could trust her. So I told her about the hidden room. That was the difference between me and Rantaro, I suppose. I had Kaede.
And Kaede's the one who killed him!
What a snake!
Hey, so what are you guys talking about? Is this something I forgot?
I don't know anything about what they're saying.
Is this something that transpired before we were born?
So what's your point? You know who Rantaro was and why he did what he did. But it's pointless now, isn't it?
No, it's not pointless. Now that we know this new information, if we look back at Rantaro's case, we can find a new truth that we missed at the time.
A new truth?
I don't really get it, but we just need to look at Rantaro's case again, right?
Then let's do it.
Yes, let's do this together.
With my vast magical powers, I'll turn Monokuma into an omnibus.
What?
I don't really get that either, but I guess we're gonna republish Monokuma.
I'm not too sure either, but the real battle is just beginning. We'll prove that the result was wrong and corner the mastermind together.
Rantaro went to the library just before Monokuma's time limit expired.
Using the information provided by the survivor card, he made his way to the hidden door.
To expose the identity of the mastermind.
But before he could achieve that goal, he got hit in the head with a shot put ball and died.
Because of Kaede's fully automatic killing machine!
Eh? Fully automatic?
There was no culprit at the scene. The only one in the library at the time of the murder was Rantaro himself!
That's a fact, right?
The camera went off just before the incident. And only Rantaro was in the picture.
Rantaro was the only one at the scene. That's what we concluded at the first trial. But was it really true?
Rantaro went to the library. Just before Monokuma's time limit expired.
Using the information provided by the survivor card, he made his way to the hidden door.
To expose the identity of the mastermind.
But before he could achieve that goal, he got hit in the head with a shot put ball and died.
Because of Kaede's full...
That's wrong!
No, Rantaro was not the only one in the library at the time the murder occurred. This survivor perk monopad is proof of that.
Why would that monopad be evidence?
The monopad was given exclusively to Rantaro as his survivor perk, correct? But when we searched Rantaro's body, he didn't have it on his person.
He only had his student handbook monopad. Which means that someone took this monopad from Rantaro after the murder.
That's very wrong!
Wow! That's what we've been saying!
What? Keep quiet, will you? I don't have time for your nonsense right now.
Really? I have no clue what anyone is talking about.
If we don't chime in soon, Pops is gonna push the detonator.
Then we better not let these fucking chumps run their mouths anymore!
A bloody monopad is disgusting! You should wash it right away!
That's not a real rebuttal!
Someone stole the Survivor Perk monopad! Where's the proof?
No way there's a bloody thief!
I can't waste time like this. I gotta finish this quickly.
A bloody monopad is disgusting! You should wash it right away!
That's not a real rebuttal!
Someone stole the Survivor Perk monopad! Where's the proof?
No way there's a bloody thief!
But remember, Rantaro brought the Survivor Perk monopad to the library. If it's missing now, that must mean someone stole it.
He brought that monopad to the library?
I think there's maybe no way that Pop...
All he had on him was the student handbook monopad! He didn't bring the Survivor Perk with him!
Damn it!
You cannot assert it was stolen.
Yep, that's right!
The hole in the argument is clear. I'll counter it right now.
He brought that monopad to the library?
I think there's maybe no way that's possible.
All he had on him was the student handbook monopad! He didn't bring the Survivor Perk with him!
I'll cut through your words!
You see it in the photo.
No, there is no doubt Rantaro brought the Survivor Perk monopad to the library. The picture taken just before he died clearly shows him holding it.
That could be his student handbook monopad, bro! You fucking know!
No, it was definitely this same monopad. You see the way the blood is dried here? The outline of his fingers matches how he was holding it in the picture.
You're right!
Shortly after this photo was taken, Rantaro was struck in the head by the shot put ball. Do you think that's when this bloody outline on the monopad was formed? I do. That's why the monopad Rantaro is holding in this picture. Has to be the same monopad we have now.
What?
Come on, no overreacting! It makes us look like we're not paying attention!
Scream all you want! Monosuke's the one that's gonna get blown up!
God.
Into bottomless ravines to kill them.
They don't kill them.
So there was a thief, huh? I can't believe someone would do something so evil.
So who took the monopad? Do you know anything else?
Do we know anything about the person who took Nantado's monopad? Yes, I think we do. Let me get the facts straight and think. Well, we know they had access to the hidden room. I'm trying to see what the billboards are. How many monopads did Lantaro have in the library? He had two. Which monopad was taken away? Survivor perk monopad. Okay, two more. I only have room in my car for three babes. They're glitching. Oh, that's the interview with Makoto. Where was that monopad taken to? Hidden room. Damn it. So bad at this. Fuck. Oh my God. I'll get some stationary ones. Who can enter the hidden room? The mastermind.
The one who took that monopath is the mastermind. I'm sure of it.
The mastermind?
The survivor perk monopath was found in the library's hidden room. And only the mastermind would have been able to enter that room, correct?
Between the time Rentaro died and when we found him, they put that monopath in the hidden room?
Nope! That's impossible!
Impossible? Why?
Huh? You don't know? Why, even my cute little cubs have already figured it out!
Huh? We have!
so I'll let Monotaro explain.
Huh? I've already forgotten what we're even talking about.
Oh crap, he's gonna push it! It's gonna be Monokid all over again!
The mastermind is not in any of the photos taken in the library. Why is that?
Huh?
Oh, that's true.
You remember what Miyu said? We thought it was a red herring.
The hidden room, you need to move the bookcase, right? But Shuichi and Kaede set up those hidden cameras, so... If the mastermind was using that door, they would have been caught on camera.
But none of the pictures showed anyone like that.
Then, that reasoning is wrong.
Amazing, Monodon! Well done!
Hold on. The hidden cameras in the library had interval timers.
After the shutter snaps, the camera can't take a new photo for 30 seconds. Because I redesigned the cameras to auto-roll the film instead of having to do it manually.
Perhaps the mastermind worked within that 30-second interval?
I see. So the mastermind hid in the hidden room, waited for the right timing, grabbed the monopad from the library, and then returned to the hidden room.
Hold on! There's a flaw in your logic.
What? What flaw?
Huh? Don't ask me! The Mono Cubs are gonna explain it! What? Again?
Daddy, why do we have to do all your work?
No logic without explaining why. That's the Monokuma debate style. Take it from here, Mono Cubs. And you better use your brains or I'll kill ya.
What are we arguing about again?
The hidden camera! Isn't it weird that the mastermind's not in any photos?
Unless they use the interval between shots.
The camera has a 30-second interval between shots. That's enough time to take the monopad from the body.
Then where was the mastermind hiding?
In the hidden room, of course!
If they were still inside the hidden room, how would they know what was happening in the library?
If you don't know when the camera went off, how would you know the interval timing?
Bravo, Monodon! Wonderful objection!
Now we've escaped certain death!
Oh, you haven't. I know the mastermind was trying to time it. And of course, the mastermind would be able to hit the right timing.
Surveillance cameras.
What? Where would something like that be?
You don't know? Even though they're monocubs just like you?
Monocubs?
I mean these.
they're your siblings, too!
Two?
That's a big reveal to drop so casually.
These little guys are called Nanokumas. Their job is to monitor the campus.
Right now, how do you know that?
Threshold of an amazing adventure.
Oh, Father told me. He said to make sure I told everyone.
And you didn't.
I had completely forgotten about it. Good thing I just remembered.
Dumbass! You remembered too late.
Two.
There are countless Nanokumas buzzing all over the campus.
No, not now. Oh my god.
All the footage they record is wirelessly transmitted through Mother Kuma. And then sent to Monokuma.
Yes, via Mother Kuma. That's an important point. If Mother Kuma receives the camera feeds, the Mastermind could ask it anything. They would know about the situation in the library and the hidden room.
I see! Mother Kuma can tell them the interval timers for the cameras!
Then the Mastermind was in the hidden room after they stole the monopad from Rentaro.
But why would they steal the monopad?
The Mastermind was probably terrified by the idea of us picking up Rantaro's perk.
No, that's wrong!
What?
I wasn't necessarily afraid. The survivor perk was for Rantaro's eyes only. Sure, he could have shared the info with you. But that's not the same as getting the info directly from the monopad. Cause then, you can't say it was a survivor perk for Rantaro's eyes only, right? So when he died, I took it back. That's all.
I don't know about that.
Hmm. How do you figure?
You look calm now, but at the time, you must have been pretty desperate. The monopad clearly stated that there was a mastermind in the academy. If we knew then that a mastermind was behind everything, we would have worked together. But you couldn't let that happen. You needed us to go after each other.
Either way, you admit the Mastermind stole the monopad, right?
Well, yes, but only reluctantly.
Then the Mastermind messed up. If they wanted to retrieve the monopad, they should have used Monokuma to do it.
Nope, that's impossible. The rules state I can't participate in a murder, which includes tampering with the crime scene.
The school rules.
If you're so strict about following the rules, does that mean that someone is watching? If that's the case...
Still, what a waste of a survivor perk! If only he lived a little longer, then this info would have made things interesting!
Yeah, stop changing the subject!
I still don't have the whole picture, but it seems that we're all being watched. In that case, this plan should go well. If I ruin this killing game by proving that it doesn't follow its own rules, I should be able to end the whole thing.
His survivor perk shouldn't affect it whatsoever. In the end, Kaede killed him. There's no shaking off that truth.
Yeah, yeah!
One truth prevails!
No, that's not the truth. I'm certain of that. It's a lie that you made up.
Me? Why?
That's right. Kaede wasn't the one who killed Rantaro. The true culprit is... That's it! The mastermind controlling Monokuma. They're the one who killed Rantaro.
The mastermind is the culprit?
Jeez, and you call yourself the ultimate detective? Trying to overturn the results of the first-class trial. The Mono Cubs won't be silent about this!
What? Us again?
But we said we don't know!
These poor kids.
If Rantaro's killer is the mastermind, that means Kaede was the mastermind!
Can you prove the mastermind is the culprit?
Yeah! Got any evidence?
You want evidence Kaede is the culprit? The shot put ball at the murder scene! She used the camera flash to lure Rantaro in, and then cracked his skull with a shot put ball!
Yep, yep, Kaede set up the whole thing! Even the lethal shot put ball! Kaede had it all along!
See? Kaede's the mastermind after all! Why so interested in dead people? You wanna crack open a cold one?
If I can just show that Kaede isn't the culprit, their argument falls apart. I should have evidence of that.
During the investigation is this. The shot put ball that Rantaro was killed with was different than the one Kaede had.
What'd you say? I have no idea what's going on!
A different shot put ball? What do you mean?
I found a shot put ball in the trash can in the hidden room. But it was not the murder weapon. That shot put ball didn't have any blood on it. Rather, there was a pink fiber stuck to that shot.
Pink fiber? So what?
Do you remember how Kaede was carrying the shot put ball?
Kaede's backpack. She was carrying the shot put ball in there. Despite its weight, it would have been easy to carry in a backpack. I noticed you also had a spare vest, which you could have wrapped it in. That would prevent the cameras you were carrying from being damaged.
I see. She had it in her backpack.
It was wrapped in her spare vest. Her pink vest.
I see. The shot put ball you found in the hidden room had a pink fiber on it.
Yes, it's a fiber from her vest. That can only mean that the ball I found was the one that was in Kaede's backpack.
What'd you say? Really, I got no idea what you're talking about.
That shot put ball did not have blood on it, so it could not have been the murder weapon. In short, the shot that Kaede used didn't hit Rantaro.
Maybe they just washed off the blood.
If so, the fiber on the shot put ball would have been washed off as well. It's clear to me that the real murder weapon is different than the shot Kaede had. Yes, Kaede set up the bookcase and rolled the shot into the vent. But that shot didn't hit Rantaro. Her plan failed.
Failed? I don't even know what that means!
If you found that shot put ball in the hidden room, then that means...
I found the shot put ball in the hidden room because...
Mastermind took it from the library. Only they could get in that room, after all.
The Mastermind took it?
So they recovered the shot that missed Rantaro, and he was killed by a different one. Rantaro was killed by the Mastermind, who made it look like Kaede was the culprit. That required a bit of trickery on the Mastermind's part. They prepared their own shot to kill Rantaro, and switched it with Kaede's shot. They took Kaede's shot put ball and stowed it in the hidden room. To put it simply, Kaede didn't kill Rantaro. It was the Mastermind.
What?
Did you?
Everyone, calm down. Father is going to yell.
What? Monotum, why? Whoops! I got too worked up and accidentally pressed the detonator!
Oh, it's blue.
The Mastermind killed Rantaro? But why?
I believe the reason had something to do with a time limit motive.
A time limit is now in effect. If a murder does not occur by nighttime 2 days from now, then every student forced to participate in this killing game will die.
Kaede was keeping us all together, and we refused to kill each other. To break up the stalemate, the Mastermind introduced that motive. However, this was a gamble. They didn't want to cause total chaos, after all.
Because that would just end everything. They wanted an exciting killing game.
That motive put pressure on the Mastermind, as well as us.
Yes, Kaede had a plan to kill the Mastermind, but Rantaro was caught in the trap. However, her plan ultimately failed. The shot put ball that she rolled didn't hit Rantaro.
Because it missed, we would have been annihilated due to the time limit. But the Mastermind wanted to avoid that situation, so they took action.
Thanks to the Nanokumas, the Mastermind would have known Kaede's intended murder weapon. So when her plan failed, they would already have another shot put ball prepared.
Then, the Mastermind manipulated the scene to make it look like Kaede succeeded. All they had to do was hide Kaede's shot in the hidden room that only they could enter.
So, Kaede was executed on false charges?
Yes. Yes, she was. She didn't actually kill anyone. But she was executed nonetheless. Because the Mastermind framed her for Rantaro's murder. And Monokuma played along. He let us believe the Mastermind's lie. We were all fooled, including Kaede. We thought she was the culprit until the very end. And you want to tell us this game is fair? That there are rules? That's all bullshit! This game makes no sense at all.
If Monokuma twisted the truth for this case, then he could have twisted it for the other cases as well, making this killing game unfair.
Then, it's not even a killing game anymore. It's just... killing.
I won't forgive them. I'll never forgive them for breaking the rules and killing Kaede. So cruel. I'll never forgive them. And I will avenge Kaede. I swear on her kindness and her love and her grave that I will avenge her.
Yeah! How dare the Mastermind create the detonator that blew up the adorable Monodum!
You're the one that blew him up!
Mastermind is also Rantaro's killer. Let's figure out who that is.
That is, if Monokuma still wants to continue this class trial.
Of course we're gonna keep going! Like I said, this killing game will never end!
No, Monokuma. I will end this. I will reveal the identity of the Mastermind and end the killing game!
You keep accusing this so-called mastermind, but... are you sure there's even a mastermind at all?
Are you sure you bastards aren't imagining it? If the mastermind is real, show him to us!
You guys are the ones hiding them!
It's possible the mastermind is still in this academy. The survivor perk said so.
If they were involved in Rantaro's murder, there's no doubt.
Then they must have snuck in during the Gopher Project and stayed hidden in the account. Ah!
You just odd! What was that all about?
I just realized something.
Say it, or I'll cast my all the guys you date will be single fathers curse.
And that's a bad thing?
It's Kaede's younger twin sister!
Her what?
Younger twin sister?
It was on this Gopher Project participant list. She has a twin sister! It seems sort of weird to me. Junko and Oshima had a twin too, right?
Are you saying those same circumstances apply here as well?
This killing game was influenced a lot by the past one, right? So maybe the Mastermind's real identity was too!
The Mastermind who snuck into the Academy and made us play this sick game is Kaede's twin sister?
Either way, there's no doubt that the Mastermind is hiding somewhere in this school.
How unfortunate that you couldn't find them during your final investigation. You're not allowed to leave while the trial's in session, so you can't search for them now. You can't leave during a trial unless you gotta pee.
Oh, I gotta pee.
We're not falling for that one.
Kaede's twin sister. Is the Mastermind still hiding somewhere? Is she really the Mastermind? Is it really that simple? Pull that trick twice?
Can you guys figure out the identity of the Mastermind?
Besides the 16 of us at this school, there was a 17th person too! That 17th person is the Mastermind!
It could be Kaede's younger twin sister. Just like the previous killing game, the Mastermind might have a twin for this game too.
If it really is the same as the previous killing game, then Kaede would still be alive. And she could potentially be the Mastermind.
Who cares? You're still no closer to the answer!
No leaving while the trial's in session!
According to the list of the Gopher Project participants, Kaede had a twin sister. Maybe it's correct, but we have to determine something first.
Can you guys figure out the identity of the mastermind?
Besides the 16 of us at this school, there was a 17th.
Mastermind!
That's wrong!
That was kind of hard.
No, the mastermind can't be a 17th person. That contradicts what Mother Kuma said.
The one you're all looking for comes to this room quite often.
It implies that the mastermind wasn't in the hidden room the whole time. They must have been coming and going between the room and the academy, right? Would someone who has to stay completely hidden really risk that?
Right. If they were trying to hide, they would have just stayed put.
I see. That's some impressive logic.
Don't agree with him.
And during the investigation, I found a classroom that makes flashback lights.
A classroom that makes flashback lights?
I'll explain the details later. But there was something interesting.
Right at that moment, the classroom door suddenly burst open. Whoosh!
There you are, Shuichi!
Himiko! Huh? The classroom changed back to normal.
When the door is opened, the classroom reverts to its original state. Clearly, the room is hiding something.
Isn't it obvious? The mastermind didn't want anyone to see them making flashback lights.
But why create such a classroom at all? If the mastermind were a 17th person, they could have their own completely separate room to make flashback lights.
Indeed, that would be much safer.
Knowing this, we can make a few assumptions about the mastermind's identity. However, the implications aren't good.
What an ominous way to say it. But there's nothing to worry about. We got this far because we're friends. We're in this together no matter what. There's nothing to fear.
Yeah, she's right.
The mastermind's identity. Considering the facts we have, my detective work points to.
That's it! The mastermind is most likely one of the participants of this killing game.
One of the participants?
One of the 16 people who were forced to play this game. One of us.
What did you say?
The classroom that makes flashback lights and the hidden room being visited often. It all suggests that the mastermind is someone we'd see every day at the academy.
Someone we'd see every day? Like one of the 16 students?
That's crazy! There's no way one of us is the mastermind! Because we're all friends! We swore to fight together!
Then it just means that all your friendship talk was a lie, right?
Shut up! That's not possible!
You're upset and irrational. At times like this, a voice of reason is necessary. Absolutely necessary.
Got it. We're up.
God.
All right. We're gonna put on a reasonable yet outstanding show and earn our right to live.
Eh? Our right to live? Is someone about to die? Is that what's going on?
Wait. Even if it's one of the 16 students, it doesn't mean it's one of us, does it?
Huh? What do you mean?
It's possible that the mastermind merely faked their death and has been alive this whole time. Now that we know Monokuma will break rules as he sees fit, that possibility should be...
What's that supposed to mean? Hurry up and answer! If you don't hurry up, I'm gonna blow up the rest of the Monokubs!
The identity of the mastermind. Once we determine who killed Rantaro, I need to confirm something to find out who that is. What I need to determine to uncover the mastermind is...
That's it! We need to go over everyone's alibi for Rantaro's murder again.
Our alibi from way back then?
Didn't we discuss that during the first trial? What good would it do to discuss it again? Now that we know Rantaro was killed by the mastermind, it might lead somewhere. We might find a hole in someone's alibi that we didn't see at the time.
So we just have to give our alibis again.
Fine. Then let's do it. So we can be sure that the mastermind's not one of us.
I wonder where this discussion will lead.
I just want to apologize real quick if you're hearing sirens. Every week, every Friday at 11, they test them. That's what's happening. Okay.
Will it lead to a mastermind in this very room? Or not? Either way, we're gonna make sure this trial stays exciting!
I was in the game room in the basement with Kaito and Gonta and Maki. Also, Tenko and Angie were there too.
Even if I was in the same basement, it's impossible for me to have killed Rantaro.
Hey! I didn't kill Rantaro either!
I was in my room by myself. And so were Ryoma and Kokichi, too. I know that is a poor alibi, but... I did not kill Rantaro!
I was in the dining hall. Kyo, Miu, and Kirumi were with me. Though I did leave briefly to use the bathroom. I couldn't have killed Rantaro.
Aww.
That's wrong.
Normally I go through all of them, but no, I wanted to get through this.
Wait a minute, Tsumugi.
Huh?
You said you went to the bathroom.
It's true. I went to the restroom closest to the dining hall.
The girls' bathroom near the dining hall, right?
What did you say? That bathroom?
Huh? What? What about it?
Shuichi, didn't you investigate the girls' bathroom? Did you find anything?
The utility closet in that bathroom has a hidden passageway. One that's connected to the hidden room in the back of the library. Which means it's possible to get into the hidden room from that bathroom.
What?
Around the time Rantaro was killed, Tsumugi went to that exact bathroom. I'm positive that when Rantaro was killed, the culprit was in the hidden room. It's too convenient to be coincidence.
Hold on. This is all so sudden. I don't think I understand.
But maybe they got there from the hidden door in the library instead.
No, I don't think so. Remember that I had placed dust in the card reader in the library. I was trying to determine if the hidden door was opened with a card reader. But the dust didn't fall. That means nobody used that card reader.
So, to enter the hidden room, they would need to use a different route. The girls' bathroom.
Yes, I believe that's the case. The culprit entered the hidden room from the girls' bathroom on the first floor. And with the help of Mother Kuma, watched the situation in the library unfold. As soon as they saw that Kaede's plan failed, they waited for the camera interval. And leaped out of the hidden room, shot put ball in hand. The hidden door could open from the inside, so there was no need to use the card reader. In any case, the culprit attacked Rantaro with a shot put ball, left it in the library, picked up the shot that Kaede had used, and returned to the hidden room.
And they also took the survivor perk monopad that Rantaro had, right?
Yes, then they left the monopad and the shot in the hidden room, headed into the passageway, and returned to the girls' bathroom.
Are you saying the one who did it was Samugi?
No! It has to be some kind of mistake! Up till now, everything pointed to the mastermind not being one of us!
Is Samugi even capable of doing all this? He's just a cosplayer, you know?
Yeah! All this would be impossible for just some cosplayer!
But you said that you went to that bathroom during Rantaro's murder. How can you possibly refute that fact?
Refute? It's all just a coincidence. Oh! Kibo and Ryoma didn't have alibis! What if they went to the girls' bathroom?
Did you see one of them in the girls' bathroom?
What?
If one of them had gone into that bathroom, you would have seen each other, right? But you never mentioned that.
Mugi, what's the meaning of this?
Can this really be true?
Mugi, is this true?
No, it's not! I really only went to use the bathroom. I didn't know about the hidden passage.
Look lively, Mono Cubs! You're up! Move your asses!
That's very wrong!
Father's never yelled at me like that before.
If we don't do well here, we're all gonna get blown up together.
No!
We don't wanna die!
We're like snowflakes! We're one of a kind!
I don't know what Four Eyes is talking about! Bad guys never wear glasses!
Anyway, just cut it out! We don't wanna die!
Stop moving! I don't care what you say, it's too late now. I won't back down.
We don't wanna die!
We're like snowflakes! We're one of a kind!
I don't know what Four Eyes is talking about. Bad guys never wear glasses.
Anyway, just cut it out! We don't wanna die!
Monokuma and the Mastermind are the bad guys here. You don't want to die? Do you know how many of my friends were sacrificed?
Please, help us!
It's
four eyes over there really the mastermind? We don't know anything.
God damn it.
I don't wanna explode.
Even if she is the culprit.
Hey, let's just stop this.
There's no evidence that she's the mastermind.
The evidence points to Tsumugi being the mastermind. I didn't notice it at the time, but now I know for sure.
Please, help us!
Is Four Eyes over there really the mastermind? We don't know anything!
I don't wanna explode!
Even if she is the culprit.
Hey, let's just stop this!
There's no evidence that she's the mastermind!
I'll cut through your words! Before being destroyed, Mother Kuma told us something.
I have a built-in voice print authentication system. I can't birth Monokumas unless the designated person specifically says the word birth.
That individual is, of course, the mastermind.
When the mastermind commands Mother Kuma to give birth, it makes a spare.
We all tried it out.
But Kiba wasn't there, was he?
Right, because I was fighting the Exosols.
Did you hear that? Kiba didn't try giving Mother Kuma a command. So the real mastermind is...
Tsumugi was the only one who didn't say, give birth.
Huh?
Everyone else said, give birth.
Whatever! Just give birth to a Monokuma!
Are you listening? We said to give birth to a new Monokuma. Hurry up and give birth to a Monokuma.
Tsumugi specifically used a different phrase.
Yeah, try and make a new Monokuma!
You didn't say give birth. You said make. You knew how to get Mother Kuma to create a spare, didn't you? That's why you specifically said make. If you had said give birth, Mother Kuma would have made a spare. Am I right, Tsumugi?
Hey, come on. What's wrong? Don't be like that, Shuichi. Do you really think I'm the mastermind? There's just no way. Hey, everyone, say something. I'm not the mastermind. That's crazy, right?
Then refute it. We're waiting.
Huh?
I don't want to believe it either, that one of our friends, the survivors, could do this. That's why I'm begging, Tsumugi. I'm begging you to refute me. I might be wrong. I was wrong before, about Kaede. That's why I need everyone's help. I don't care if my detective work is wrong. I want to hear your argument. Reaching the truth together is what cooperation means to me.
Tsumugi, please.
Tsumugi, please!
What's the matter? You can't argue back after hearing that.
Whoa, hold on. I don't know what's going on right now, but just hold on a sec!
Oh, Monosuke's infamous impatience rears its ugly head.
And what an ugly head it is.
I don't think friends should blame each other like this, you know? Come on, smile, everyone. I know, we could watch a comedy special so we could all smile.
Jeez, you're noisy.
Wow!
Monosuke. You loved Monosuke so much.
Oh yeah, you're right. But we're at the good part now. So be quiet and watch like good little cubs.
Father?
See? It's getting exciting. Shuichi is trying to reveal the mastermind, trying to overcome despair. It's so heart-pounding!
We have the mastermind cornered. Why is Monokuma so calm? He should be feeling cornered as well. Forget it. We're on the offensive here. If we make the mastermind's identity clear, all this will be settled. You're the only one.
It has to be you. Mastermind of this killing game. And the culprit who killed Rantaro. It's you, Tsurugi. There are no other possibilities. You don't have anything to say?
Anything to say? Even if you keep saying all that stuff, I still don't get it. Hey, let's stop this already. You're mistaken. It's because we're all friends, right? Weren't we going to work together to end this killing game?
This is a class trial. Although we were forced into these class trials by the mastermind, that's how we survived. It was the only way. It was the only way we could survive. So please, Tsurugi, refute the evidence. Say something. Your life depends on it. Please.
Tsurugi, I don't want to suspect you. I want to believe in you. I want the mastermind to be somewhere else, like in the previous killing games. So, if you're really not the mastermind, then don't give up. I'll cheer you on.
Even if you say that...
Tsurugi is taking her sweet time, but waiting around is so boring. Hey, Shuichi! Why don't we look over the case again?
What?
Come on, that's like your thing. Present the truth and end this. Because there are people who don't know what the heck is going on until we get to this part. Now then, let's start!
Oh, we're getting to that right now. Okay, let's see here. The people in the dining hall. What's this? Where is the mastermind? No, not there. Survivor perk. Shuichi runs. Thank you.
This is the truth of the case. With this new evidence, let's look back at Rantaro's murder. The night of the incident, Kaede and I were in the first floor classroom. We were waiting for the mastermind to trigger the trap we set in the library. Around that time, there were four people in the dining hall, including the mastermind. The mastermind was probably irritated that no murders had yet occurred. After the motive was given, they knew that Kaede was planning something. But the mastermind wanted some insurance. They would take action if necessary. The mastermind excused themselves from the dining hall and went to the bathroom. And from there, to the hidden room in the library that only the mastermind could enter. And there they waited. With less than an hour before the time limit expired, Rantaro moved the library's bookcase, which set off the receiver I was holding. It all happened the way we determined in the first trial, except at the end. I ran out of the room, and Kaede rolled the shot put ball into the air vent. At the same time, Rantaro was lured by the flash of the hidden camera Kaede set. He unwittingly stepped right into the path of the shot. The shot rolled down the path Kaede made, and then... fell right onto Rantaro's head, killing him instantly. Or so we thought. It turns out, that was just what the mastermind wanted us to believe. In reality, Kaede's murder plan happened quite differently. The shot put ball that Kaede rolled didn't actually hit Rantaro. He must have been surprised seeing the shot put ball drop out of nowhere like that. But his fate was sealed. The mastermind saw that Kaede's plan failed and stepped in to finish the job. The mastermind jumped out of the hidden room and attacked Rantaro from behind. And in their hand, the real murder weapon, their own shot put ball. Rantaro wasn't killed by Kaede's shot, but by the mastermind's. The mastermind picked up Kaede's shot and left their shot put ball at the scene. They also looted the Survivor Perk Monopad from Rantaro's body. Those things in hand, they retreated back into the hidden room. I remember seeing the bookcase closing just as Kaede and I got there. The mastermind had probably just finished their crime. And so, the real truth was perfectly hidden from us. We went to the class trial and reached the truth that Kaede was the culprit. But that truth had been twisted by the mastermind. After the murder, the mastermind left the stolen monopad on the table in the hidden room. And threw Coyote's shot put ball into the trash can. A little careless of them to not get rid of all the evidence. They probably believed no one would ever get into that room, but we did. Their crime complete, the mastermind went back through the hidden passageway. The passageway led from the hidden room all the way to the girls' bathroom on the first floor. While the mastermind was pretending to use the girls' bathroom, they were actually using the hidden passageway. That's how they moved around without being noticed. Anyone could have used the hidden passageway, not just the people in the dining hall. But looking at the survivors, only you could possibly be the mastermind. If I'm wrong, please refute me. Please tell us you aren't the mastermind, Tsumugi Shirogane, the ultimate cosplayer. That's the truth of this case, of the killing game itself. Well, Tsumugi?
Well, what?
Yes! What a scorching hot twist! My hand holding the detonator is tensing up! Don't get tense! Calm down!
Daddy! Please stop this! Go back to how you used to be! When you loved yourself so much!
How I used to be was more suited to a different story than this one. Doesn't matter. I gotta watch this exciting development!
Well, Tsumugi, are there any flaws in Shuichi's logic? If so, then please tell us.
Flaws? There's a bunch of flaws all over it!
Then explain.
You can do it! You can do it, Tsumugi!
Even if you cheer me on, it's not like that! I didn't do it! It's plain to see!
Fight back, Tsumugi! Come on! You can do it! You can do it!
Daddy, you're tensing up again!
I still want to live, so please, don't push the button!
Tsumugi, please, just say something! If you don't defend yourself...
It's Junko Inoshima!
What?
Cause it's always been her. In the Hope's Peak killing game, and in the Jabberwock Island killing game. Junko Inoshima didn't participate. She controlled the game from outside. Even if it's boring or repetitive, she's always the mastermind, isn't she? And it's like that this time too. It's gotta be Junko again!
Junko Inoshima is dead. She's not part of this killing game.
You're wrong. She hasn't been eliminated. It's all Junko's doing. This killing game is her doing too. Yeah, that's gotta be it. Cause Junko Inoshima is...
Junko Inoshima is...
Cause Junko Inoshima is...
Junko Inoshima is...
Daddy, please don't get so excited! You pressed the button by accident!
Look at our cute faces! Can you really bear to be without us?
Junko Inoshima is...
Junko Inoshima is what?!
Okay, time for a commercial break.
We're a good comedy group, too! So please, don't